450 million people live beyond this gateway to India. This is the port of Bombay, the fringe of India, as New Zealanders saw it when they passed through on their voyages. Here at home, we see India only in the newspaper headlines, a mixture of Kipling, Mahatma Gandhi, the Taj Mahal, and Sir Stafford Cripps. But the India beyond Bombay showed something of its real self to our men as they stayed for a while on the edge of this potentially great and rich nation. Behind the fine buildings, they saw some of the teeming millions for whom Britain is now attempting to organize self-government. For thousands of years, they have lived close-packed between the Himalayas and the ocean. Now comes their opportunity to catch up on the racing progress of civilization, on the steady processes of government that develop democracy. Great buildings symbolize India's richness. The people over whose soil they stand symbolize all the peoples all over the world whose destinies come in these years to the point of decision. India has been offered a chance to fight for future aims. In this, New Zealand will wish her well. Tobacco isn't rationed here. We can still import it, and better still, we can grow our own. But it's not so easy for our men in other countries. There's no time to get fat in an army. No time to go off to the store and buy your own. Not much money to buy a smoke, even if the canteen is handy. But we can help them, just by filling in a form. By arrangement with the National Patriotic Fund Board, any shop that displays this poster will accept payment with an order for tobacco to be sent overseas, the Middle East now included. The board buys tobacco in quantities, and women helpers pack it for sending away. Quantities required for the men at their war stations all over the world are checked from the form sent in by the tobacconist. Hundreds of parcels are then carefully packed up. The board's organization sees that each man receives his gift as far as is humanly possible. The system saves time and packing space, and helps an overburdened postal service. At first, the service could not reach our Middle East forces. Now, tobacco sent this way, duty-free, reaches Egypt as well as all the other countries where New Zealanders stand to arms. Those men over there are still part of New Zealand. Remember, a pound of tobacco is worth a ton of good wishes